So what about texture baking with metal materials? Hey everyone and welcome back to the Blender Texture Baking Mastery. Today I'm going to be talking about baking metals and how we can go about doing that. So you can see here in this example that I've got an object here with two materials. So I've got a metallic material on one side and a non-metallic material on the other side. And I want to bake all of these onto one texture map. If I press tab to go into edit mode and press A to select everything, you can see that I just have a simple cube projection here. How I done that was I just pressed A to select everything, then I pressed U, and then I chose projection. And you can see that it got us this result here in my UV editor here. I'm just going to change this back to the outliner just now, and I'm actually just going to pull out a new window to get a UV editor. So I'll come to the top left hand corner and then I'll drag this out. If you want to follow along, I do have a blend file in the description of this course, so feel free to download that if you want to follow along. Then I'm going to change my 3D viewport here to the UV editor, so we've got a UV editor as well. Now, in the first place, why would we want a metal map? Well, this can be handy, especially when you're taking it into other software, and you just want a simple texture to give your client, or maybe just to make it easier for yourself, to easily plug it into the other software's native nodes. For example, when I was doing work for a client one time, I baked a metal map and then showed them how to plug it in to Unreal Engine. And having it all as just textures can make it a lot easier. So let's jump into how we can go ahead and bake all of these. So we'll get started with the stuff we know how to do, so the base color. And to do that, I'm just going to come to my material properties here. And you can see I've got my two material slots. So I've got my basic tiles and my gold metal tiles. So I'm going to come to my basic tiles first, press Shift A, and then in texture, I'm going to add an image texture and I'll press plus new. And I'm going to call this diffuse half metal tiles. And I'll put 2K at the end as well, since we're going to make this a 2K texture. And then I'm going to left click and quickly drag down. And that's going to allow me to select both of these numbers. I can left click at the end here, hold down the shift key and type in the number 8. And that's going to give us a star. And then I can press 2, press enter. And now we've got 2048 by 2048. And I can just press new image. And now we've got a basic image to bake on. I'll keep it at RGB since this is going to be the diffuse. And then I'm going to come up to my render properties here. I'm going to make sure I'm in cycles. We've already set up the issue with Blender 4.2, so we don't need to do any of those settings. And I'm going to set my max samples under render to 10, since it's just color we're doing. And I'm going to set my bake type to diffuse. Keep contributions direct and indirect off, since we don't want to bake any lighting from our scene. And we just want to have color, since that's just the basic color channel that we'll be baking that. As you know, if we left click this node tree here, when we bake the diffuse, it's going to be baking the base color of this principal BSDF, which is plugged into our surface. And it'll be the same when we're baking the roughness. So I'll press the arrow to come back out. And what I'm going to do now is just left click my texture here. Make sure I've got my object selected. Make sure I've got all these settings the same. And I can just go ahead and press bake. And you'll notice that our bake is going to turn out like this. And this is actually going to cause some issues because even if we got it so it was half-half, it would actually be impossible for us to apply it to this object as it is just now. So what we can do instead is we can use a second UV map and bake onto that instead. And that will help us solve our first problem. So to do that, it's actually very simple. We'll just come to this green triangle here, and here where it says UV maps, you can just open this. You can press the plus button, and now this will allow us to create a second UV map. When I press tab to go into edit mode, you can see when we have it selected, it's going to show our UV map. So right now you can see it's just a duplicate of our other UV map. Notice how when I left between these, it's still the same. So I'll left click my second one, and then I'm just going to press A to select everything, U, and then we'll choose our smart UV project. Keep your idle margin at 0.01 and press unwrap. And now you can see we have our unwrap here. If you've scaled this object at all, make sure to apply the scale in object mode first. But since we haven't touched this, this will work just fine. You'll notice again now, if I left click my other UV map, it's going to toggle between the cube projection and this smart UV project. And this smart UV project will be more ideal for this bake. Now I'll go ahead and I'll left click my texture again. And then I'm going to come up to my render properties, scroll down, and I'm going to bake again. And it's not shown up in the UV editor here, but I can just drag this out and then I can choose it from here. And you can see that it's now baked it in all only these areas, which is perfect, just what we're needing. And now we just need to bake the other part, which would be the gold part. So of course, because we've just done some baking, let's go ahead and save this image. So I'll press image and then I'll choose save. And I'm going to find a suitable location to save them. And then I'm just going to create a new folder called half metal tiles textures. And then I'll put in 2K afterwards. And I'm just going to double click that to open it. And then I'm just going to save as image. Then we'll come down to our material properties. and I'm going to switch to the gold metal tile slot. And then in here, I'll press Shift A, then under texture, I'll choose image texture. And then in this drop down here, we just choose our diffuse half metal tiles again. Now, something you'll find if we were to bake just now is going to just create black areas here. And that's because for some reason, it doesn't seem to like the metallic slider. So whenever you encounter this issue when baking metals, all you need to do is left click this button here to go into the node tree. And this metallic slider, we're just going to turn to zero. If I press tab to come into object mode, you'll notice that even though we've changed the slider to zero, it's still looking metallic. That's because I've set the IOR to gold. So even when we have metallic off, it's still going to kind of create the reflections that a gold material would have. So even though it's not looking yellow, don't worry, it will look yellow in the texture. And all I need to do now is come up by pressing this arrow if you haven't already. And then I can left click my texture, make sure I've got my object selected, come up to my render properties, scroll down to bake, and then just choose bake again. Awesome. And now you can see we've got the yellow tiles here as well for our gold. And then what we can do is we can just left click image and we can choose save. And that's just going to go ahead and override the last time we saved this texture. So it will have all of our changes added. And great, that has now done the base color. Let's go ahead and move on to the roughness. So I'm going to come to my material properties. And then I'm going to come back to my basic tile slot. I'll left click this texture here and press Shift D to duplicate it. Then I'll press the X to remove its texture so I can add a new one. And then I'll press plus new. And I'm going to call this one roughness half metal tiles 2K. Then my width and height I'll keep at 2K. And then I'm just going to go ahead and press new image. Now I'm just going to go ahead and change the color space of this roughness to non-color. Now just before we bake our roughness here, we have to do something in the other material slot. So I'm going to come to my material properties to gold metal tiles. And this we are actually going to have to get rid of it. So I'm going to left click it and then press X. Because if we were to bake the roughness, it's going to override our diffuse map because it's the active selected thing in this gold metal tiles material. So for peace of mind, I usually just delete it. And then I'll come back to my basic tiles again. And we can also delete this one here too, since we're finished with it for now. And then I can left click this roughness here, scroll down to the bottom, change the bake type to roughness. And then we can go ahead and left click bake. And now you can see it's gone ahead and baked the roughness of the non-metal side with all these nice imperfections here. Now all we need to do is we can come to our material properties, the gold metal tiles, and I'm just going to press Shift A. Then under texture, I'm going to choose image texture, and I'm going to left click this drop down and choose the roughness. And then we can come back to render properties, down to the bottom, make sure we have our object and our texture selected, and then just press bake. Awesome, and now you can see it's baked the roughness of this one here as well, and we now have a completed roughness map. So I can just go ahead and left click image, choose save, and then in my file browser, I can just save it alongside my diffuse map by just pressing save as image. Then, like I've done with the diffuse, I'm going to go ahead and delete these texts first. So I'll just left click this one and press X, and then I'm going to come back to my material properties, scroll up to the top, select basic tiles, and then I'm going to press X to remove this roughness one here. And I'm going to press plus new. And I'm going to call this one OpenGL normal half metal tiles. And I'm going to keep the resolution at 2K. And then just choose new image. And I'll change my color space here to non-color. Even though it's a normal map, we got to make sure it's non-color. And then I'm just going to left click it to select it. Make sure I've got my object selected. Then I'll come to my render properties, scroll down, and change my bake type from roughness to normal. Then I'll make sure all these settings are the same. And then I'm going to go ahead and press bake. Awesome. And now you can see it's baked half of our object here. And now all we need to do is left click this material properties, come up to the gold metal tiles, and we'll just press Shift A again. Then under texture, I'll choose image texture, left click the drop down, and I'll choose the OpenGL normal half metal tiles. Then I'll left click the texture to select it, make sure I've still got my object selected, and then I'm going to come to my render properties, scroll down, and then make sure we're still on normal, and then we can just choose bake again. Perfect, and now we have a complete normal setup. So I can just go ahead and save this, so I'll left click image, and then I'll choose save. Then in my file browser, I'll just choose save as image here, and now that should be it saved. And then we're just going to do the same thing again. I'll left click my image here, and press X to delete the node. Then I'll come to my material properties, basic tiles, and here I'm just going to press the X. And this time I'm going to press plus new and I'm going to call it metal half metal tiles and then press new image and I'll set my color space to non-color. Now all we need to do is go into our basic tile shader and we're going to come to just this principal BSDF node. To bake the metal, we're just going to use the emission. So this is really simple. You can see here the metallic slider here is zero for our non-metal shader. So all I need to do is left click my color and here we're going to want to make sure the value slider is zero and all of these ones are also zero too. And that's it. All we'll need to do then is come back up, left click this, And then we'll come to our render properties, scroll down to the bottom, and I'm going to set my bake type here to emit, and then I'm just going to left click bake, and as we expected, it's going to create just a plain black texture, pretty much just the default. And then we can go ahead and go to our material properties, left click our gold metal tile slot, press shift A, then under texture I'll choose image texture, then in this drop down I'm going to choose metal half metal tiles, then I'm going to go into my node tree again, and under emission we can set our strength here to 1, so make sure that's set to 1. And the color, we're just going to want to make sure the value is set to 1, which would match the usual metallic value of 1, which we've got turned off temporarily. Also, another thing to mention, if you had something plugged into the metal slot here, you would just plug that into the color. So just to make that clear, I'm then going to press the up button here, left click my metal tiles texture, come up to my render properties, scroll down to the bottom, and then just left click bake. Awesome, and now you can see we've got the white areas for where it's supposed to be metallic. We'll just go ahead and fix this shader now. So I'll go into the node tree again, and I'm going to change my strength here of my shader to 0, or you can just change your color here to 0 as well, and that will also work. Then we'll change our metallic value back to 1, and now it's all working again. I'll go up, and now I'm just going to save this metal map. So I'll just left click image, save, then in my file browser, I can just save it here as my metal tiles texture. And now let's go ahead and give these materials a try. So I'm going to left click my object here, press shift D, and then G and Y to move it along, and then I'm going to left click the X to remove the material, and then I'll come to my material properties, and I'm going to left click this minus button to remove all of the materials, and then we can just press plus new, and then I'm going to left click the material.001 and just call it half metal tiles bake. Now to get started with setting this up, all we need to do is press shift A, and then under texture I'm going to choose image texture, and here I can just choose my diffuse from my drop down here. Do keep in mind that if you can't find it here, you can press the open button instead and then just choose it from your file browser. Then I'm going to press shift A, and then under input I'm going to choose UV map, and then I'm going to press shift A again, and then under input I'm going to choose texture coordinate as well. Then I'm going to just plug in the UV into the vector and color into the base color. Right now you can see that it's not working properly, and that's because it's using the other UV. Remember how if I come to my green triangle here and come to my UV maps, we've got two UV maps. It's still using the default UV map. Now there's two ways we can go about this. We can keep both UV maps of this object and just select it using the UV map node. So to do that, all I would do is choose my UV map .001, which is the second UV map, and plug it into the vector, and you can see that that's now working. Or alternatively, we can just remove the first UV map here by selecting it and pressing minus, and then plugging in the UV of our texture coordinate into the vector, and that will work since it's now the only UV map. I can press Ctrl Z to undo that. Another thing we can do is we can left click the camera button beside the UV map .001, and that will now make it the default UV map, which means when I plug in my UV of my texture coordinate into the vector, it will now work as well. So a couple of different ways to go about doing that. Then I'll left click my texture here and press shift D to duplicate, and I'm going to choose from the drop down here the roughness, and I'll plug the UV into the vector, make sure my color space is non-color, and plug my color into the roughness, and now we've got some nice reflective tiles again, but we still don't have the metallic side here. So to fix that, we can just press shift D again to duplicate this selected texture. I'll zoom in, and I'm going to change it by left clicking the drop down and choosing the metal. Then I'll plug in that vector to the UV here, and then plug the color into the metallic. And now you can see it's working nicely, and we've got our metal and non-metal side all in this one set of textures. Of course, we can add our normal map as well, so I'll just left click this one here, press shift D, then in the drop down, I'm going to choose the normal map here, plug in my vector to the UV, and I'll press shift A, and then under vector, I'm going to choose normal map, plug your color into the color, and then normal into the normal. This normal map allows Blender to convert this texture into normal data. And now you can see we've got the result we were looking for. So yeah, great job. That just about covers it. This one had a lot of back and forth going on, but congratulations for making your way through the whole lesson. Feel free to share your results in the community, as I'd love to see how you got on with this one. Apart from that though, thank you so much for watching this module, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.